Hello, fellows of PLCnext. I'm Frank and I'm working on the technical support at PLCnext Germany. Today I'd like to introduce you on the OPC UA client of PLCnext Technology. And based on one of my previous tutorials, I'd like to show you how you can establish a multi-server connection with PLCnext. In my previous video, I already introduced you in a way and the process how you can establish a connection from an OPC UA client to one OPC UA server. In this scenario, it was a second PLCnext control. I implemented a roundtrip and already showed the handling of certificate. This tutorial is based on the previous one. If you haven't seen it before, please do it. I will implement here a connection to a third-party control. Even if it's a housing of the PLCnext 2152, is running on this controller called as a soft PLC. PLCnext SL. You can get this soft PLC via the PLCnext store. The setup is quite the same. I'm creating a round trip with this CODESYS control. So I'm writing on one variable and the PLC is copying this value to a second one which I'm subscribing. In addition, I add the CODESYS PLC as a second server in my client configuration. Let's get straight into it. I deployed for this application the CODESYS control for PLCnext SL app from the PLCnext store. This turns a normal X-Line F2152 to a CODESYS control. I'm using here the CODESYS software version 3.5 and the runtime version 4.6. The application itself is quite simple. I'm using two variables, a write variable and a read variable. If I'm writing from the OPC UA client a value to the write value, it will be copied to the read, so a round trip. To publish those variables to the OPC UA server, I added the symbol configuration. Activate under settings the OPC UA feature support and mark the used variables, in this case, my both variables. On the device, I modified the change runtime security policy that also an anonymous login is possible. You can now deploy this application to the PLC. Start the application. So the system is running. Okay, let's check if the OPC UA items are available and switch to the OPC UA expert test client. I used the test client in the previous tutorial, so you might switch over. The server above is the PLCnext control, so the initial controller in the project, and both variables are coming from the server. They are available on PLCnext, RPLC, ECLR. And if I send a value to the write variable, it's copied to the read variable. Okay, change over to the CODESYS server called OPC UA server. Here we'll find on the server node on the CODESYS control for PLCnext resource application and then programs our both items. I already added them in the view. And if I send here as well a value to the write variable, it is copied to the read. So the connection is running. We can now proceed in the client configuration in PLCnext Engineer. I've opened the OPC UA client application and added already two additional variables, a write and read variable with the same data type like on the CODESYS runtime. Since PLCnext Engineer 2023.9, it's not longer necessary to mark those variables as OPC. You can do it, but it's not longer necessary. If you have an earlier version, you have to activate this checkbox. Okay, go ahead and open the OPC UA node and jump into the client connection settings. I've already added an additional server to the server configuration. The name is CODESYS and it has the following IP address. As we activated the possibility for an anonymous login, you can disable the security mode and security policy URI. If you choose a security option, you might have to copy certificates to the trust store of the PLCnext. This is explained in the previous video. Now you can add to the subscribe and write group the items of CODESYS. Choose the local variable, and this is a global variable I shown before. The data type is directly detected. Choose the server which should be used, in this case, of course, the CODESYS. And now you can enter the remote variable identifier for this item. In addition, you have to choose the namespace. This can be done using the OPC UA expert. Let's go back to the OPC UA expert. You can choose a variable in this field or in the view. In any case, you see on the right upper side some details of the item. The identifier type is string in this case, and this is identifier string. You can copy this value and paste in this position. The prefix S equals sign means that this identifier is a string type, like displayed here, identifier type string. So you can type S equal and then paste the copied string identifier. Go ahead with the namespace. The namespace is also shown in the information of the item. The namespace index is in this case 4. In the PLCnext Engineer client configuration, the namespace is identified of the name, not on the namespace index. You can check the namespace name using this field. In this case, the namespace is CODESYS 3S IAC var access, or you can also check the server property namespace array, perform a double click, and then you can copy this value to the clipboard and paste it on this position. If the namespace is once typed in, you can choose the namespace later on the drop down. At the right variable, also on the right field, I've added here the OPC UA write variable with the same data type and performed the action shown like on the subscription as well here. So copied the string identifier of the item and choose the namespace. In some cases, it might be necessary to modify the timeout dates. In my case, I had to raise the timeout a bit, otherwise I received a timeout from the OPC UA server from the CODESYS runtime. Okay, now we can deploy the application to the PLC. We are online and in debug mode. Now we can check the notifications to see if the connection could be established. The notifications are also available on the web-based management. Okay, let's have a look. We have here a restart. And you can see that the connection tried to establish. We are connecting. Connection started. We are connecting to the endpoint of this IP address. And we are connecting to the endpoint of this IP address, which is the CODESYS PLC. You can see the configuration and settings of the connection. In this case, for the CODESYS, an anonymous login, and for the PLCnext with a username. So we can see here, connection state changed for the PLCnext control, connected, And we can see the same for the CODESYS controller state change connected. And if both client connection shows the value connect finished, like here and here, the connection is established and valid. Now let's test the data connection with the global variables. I can write a value to the CODESYS server and it's copied back to the client, so the round trip is working. Okay, fellas, that was all. See you next time. Have a great time. Bye-bye.